Hey guys, it's Yelchik, and I feel like I haven't talked to you guys for so long. But anyway, today I wanted to show you how to dance better. Like if you're a dancer like me, if you do ballet or Irish dance or any type of dance that you have to be that you have to be kind of flexible for and have to have good turnout and points and have good stage presence, I have some tips for you. So let's get started. Okay, guys, so let's get down to the bottom of this. So really, actually, the basis of dancing and turnout and crossing is just simple flexibility. So a great stretch for your turnout is the butterfly stretch. Okay, you guys, so honestly, once I learned how to do this, I was once I got my legs down almost to the ground, honestly, my turnout improved so much. You see, here, my hand right here, okay, see, my feet are pointing straight forward, then turn out. See, my hands are turning out too. So when your hips are stretched nicely, then it kind of like stretches right here. And your turnout comes from moving right here, your foot out, your leg out. So when it's all flexed, like all stretched, okay, so pretend like my hips are tight. It's really, really hard for you to move it out. So when you have the butterfly stretched down, your turnout will improve so much. Okay, guys, so let's talk about stage presence. You really need this for just dancing in general. You want to be able to smile. And part of stage presence is your posture, but we'll get to that later. Now, all you're really going to need for this activity is a mirror. The mirror is the best, like, this is really all you need is a mirror. Because, okay, for example, do I look good doing this? Or do I look better like this? And it just really looks like you're actually having fun doing it. So, stage presence is like one of the best qualities that you can have for dancing. Okay, so all you're gonna have to do is take a mirror, set it down, then do whatever you're supposed to do without smiling, or how you usually do it. So just do whatever. You would generally put it up higher, but I can't right now. So I'm just gonna do like this. And you notice how terrible that looks. So then you do it with a smile. And then you're gonna practice doing it with that smile and do everything that you have to do with a smile. And when you're doing it, make sure you actually are participating. And it really looks like you're having fun if you have good stage presence and you're smiling. And also, to remind yourself to smile, all you have to do is just think, am I happy? Am I having fun? And be like, yeah, I'm having fun. Yeah, I'm happy. Then I'm going to smile. Because if I'm not having fun and I'm not happy, I'll... But if I'm happy and I am having fun, so that's like a big thing. Okay, you guys, so next thing is posture. Posture is crucial to any dancing. Okay, think about this. Stand in a mirror too, could be a long mirror, and straighten yourself up. So just make sure you're standing up straight and
don't arch your back. Because I remember I used to do this when I would dance. I would be like, and it's really bad for your back and your neck. So all you're going to have to do, you want to look more like a stick. So pull your bum in, put your abs back, and just try to look as straight as possible. When you're that straight, make sure not to sag down. Now, this is one of the biggest problems ever, is when people are sagging down. This arches your back, and that is not good. So I have a really great exercise for you guys. It's really for anyone. Even if you just want to improve your posture in life at all. I mean, this is just a posture tip for anything, because it will seem like you're having so much more fun, and it'll like, for example, when you're older and you're in meetings, if you're slouched down like this, you won't seem professional, and that way you'll turn out not to look as professional, or as, you won't seem as important. So if you have good posture, you'll seem like you have more important and you're more at the top of the world. Okay, so what we're going to be doing is you're gonna squat down like this, and then you're going to go onto your tippy toes, and then you're going to stay up, and as you're going down, try to grow an inch. So go down, tippy toes, grow up, and then reach your neck to the sky. So this is really, really great for anyone, and I repeat, anyone who just really wants to improve their posture. Okay, guys, so now for your kicks. This is honestly a big thing. You do this in a lot of stuff, and in gymnastics too. So I have this awesome stretch. Once I was at a Fesher and Irish dancing competition, and she started doing it. I was like, oh my gosh, Mom, can you do that? Can you help me? Because you will need someone's help. So what you're going to do is you're going to take an object, okay? So for example, this little chair. And I'm going to take this thing. You know what? No. And so you're going to take the chair and put your leg up onto the chair. And just rest it there for a bit. Then try and take it off the chair and hold it, or the bar or whatever. And hold it, and then that will really help a lot. And then try and go on higher surfaces. So what you really can just do is just put something under it. One moment. Okay, so on my bed, I have this like little bar, if you cannot see. There it is. It is taller than the chair that I used. Okay, so this is a much better view. I'm going to take my leg, stick it onto the bar, and then after I have it up there and get used to it, I'm going to reach it up and keep it there. And put it down, back down. And reach it up and put it there for a little bit longer and put it back down. And do this for as long as you want and as much as you want, and just try and get as high as you possibly can. Okay, guys, so this is the last one, and it is for your pointing. So it's like the simplest one ever. You're just going to point it and hold it up. And it's a lot better if you hold it off the ground. Two. Just find your balance. And this one is just totally awesome. Oh, and another quick tip for your abs and your posture. Do sit-ups and these other totally awesome things. So you lay down, and then you're gonna take your legs up and do that. Hold them up like that, and then sit-ups too. And you can do curls. But another really good one is just simple planks. So that is all, you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.